not pulling me at all anymore. Right. Nothing.
So that's kind of like if you need to take a second, catch your breath.
Exactly. And let you know what happens naturally. You're gonna go down with the wind, right? The wind's gonna pull you with the kite. So when you're walking upwind, coming back, you want to fly the kite at noon.
Now, weekend turned out amazing. This is our first collaboration clinic between Cabrina and Estuary. We had 11 participants come out. They ranged from veterans to current military members to individuals that are just dealing with challenges. And they came out, they were introduced to wind sports, got out on the water, and they had an amazing time. I think they're gonna cherish this weekend for a long time and try to get into the sport forever.
We shared some really fun experiences with some people who were really open to learning how to kite and to try some new things, and all around it was just smiles from everybody.
Just need to be like this. Maybe put a hard hat on too, actually.
Yeah, I think for me and a lot of people, kiting, winging, surfing, just kind of doing something on the water where you're out there with Mother Nature is, it can change your whole day. You can be in a bad mood and go out and have a session, and I know for me, it'll change my mood. It's out there, kind of away from people, having fun, and I think for me, I'd be a different person without it.
I've been in the military for a long time and served for a long time, and you get around individuals that are just like extreme athletes, and at some point in their career, they're wounded. They lose their natural ability to do things through accidents that happen. And I was lucky enough to be introduced to sailing through a program, and I thought it was very therapeutic myself. But a lot of these guys need an extreme sport to kind of fill that void. And that's what we did this weekend. We introduced that to them.
I'm just hoping I can get back to shore.
I'm thinking I'm getting my ass handed to me.
if it's not a little intimidating, you know, it's probably not that much fun. So, you know, I mean, plus like all these guys, you know, like talk smack, you know, but I mean, we're all just out here trying to have fun. So, you know, it's a little bit intimidating, but you know, they're showing you what you're doing. They're there to help you out. You know, it's not, you know, I felt very safe.
Yeah, I think a lot of people were kind of a little unsure of how hard it would be or if it would be difficult while they were missing a leg or something like that. And I think they all did really well. I had a guy today, Matt, who did really well. And I know he was having a little bit of trouble balancing on the beach, but got him in the water and body dragging around. It's cool to see that stoke and kind of put him in the water, and he's just like everyone else at that point. And it was fun to see him get dragged around and just having fun.
Well, the cool thing about this event is it's set up to make you be able to do it. So it makes it a little less stressful, you know what I mean? Because you wouldn't normally think that someone with a disadvantage could do it, but everybody here helped me to where I'm not exactly doing it, but I definitely got a step closer to doing it.
Our project, Newfound Freedom, is actually a three-phase project. Phase one, basically this year, is to give them something to do, give them the experience. Phase two is going to be provide the ride. We're going to take our outstanding design resources at Cabrina, and we're going to make equipment that's more accessible, offers a better feel, and more opportunities for people that may have physical challenges. And then the third part of this process is going to be give them places to go. We're going to take places throughout North America, South America, and the Caribbean, and we're going to make sure that they've got equipment that makes them accessible to people who may face these certain challenges. So when they go on vacation, just like you and I, they can go with their family and their friends and have a great time on the water with great gear provided by Cabrina.
It brings good stories, and luckily we have a beer that we created together between the two companies that they can drink together and celebrate this weekend. We created a beer to help raise money for these clinics. No one's drawing a salary for it. It's going straight to flying people in, get them hotel rooms, get them out on the water, and to help, you know, with some of the logistical costs for doing this. And that's what the beer is for. Hopefully we're going to sell a lot of it and run a lot of clinics. And here, 2 years down the road, we're going to be in Hawaii or Hood River, Oregon, and we're going to run into a bunch of people that we've run through the program, and it's going to be a huge community out there for the new Freedom project. So.
Ready? Yeah. Okay.
I think I'm going to have to try it again, at the very least. Definitely.
that spark, and the next thing you know, we're passing it along. It's like a smile, you know? Once you smile, then you make another person's. It's contagious, you know?
It's fun, you should try it. I love it.
You know, if you face any challenges and you think you cannot do something, this is the program for you. I've been an amputee for over 12 years now, and you know, at one point doctors told me to not keep on going with kiting, and I didn't listen, and I'm here today, and I'm paying it for it, and I'm teaching it to others. So don't ever think that you have to stop something, and never say you can't. Just hear from the newsletters when the next event will be, and sign up.